This is the ultimate guide for mass outbreaks and massive mass outbreaks in Pokemon Legends Arceus. Let's go. So right now, a lot of people are panicking about their regular mass outbreaks because as of this 1.1.0 update, it's very different. So for example, if I was going to go ahead and I want to go and get this Golduck, I'm going to head to the Crimson Mirelands. And what people are used to doing is saving at this camp and then finding the Pokemon and checking if it's shiny. Once they check if it's shiny, they then are going to decide if it is or not, if they see the color. And if it's not, they're then going to reset their game and come back to here and exit. So let's just say I went ahead and I did that. I save at my camp. I go ahead and I go check my Golducks. We're going to hypothetically say it so I don't waste time in the video. So I go ahead and I check it. Maybe it's shiny, maybe it's not. Let's say it's not shiny. I'm then going to reset my game, come back to this camp, and then exit. When I exit this area, I'm then going to go back to the village, come back and expect me to see the Golducks. But the problem with the 1.1.0 update is they removed this. So when you go and look back at your map again, you'll probably also see that it's gone. You can also see that the other mass outbreak that was here has also changed into a Scyther. So if you are regular mass outbreak hunting, what you have to do now is just go and hopefully you have good shiny luck and get it on the first try. Unfortunately, if you have a favorite Pokemon that showed up, you're gonna have to wait for the rotation to come back. That's it for regular mass outbreak hunting. Now let's talk about these massive mass outbreaks. As you see, if you open up your map, you're going to get a question mark, right? And this is the Obsidian Fieldlands, for example. So we're gonna go ahead and click on the Obsidian Fieldlands and go over to the area. Once we are in the Obsidian Fieldlands, you're then going to go ahead and talk to Mai. And you're going to have a specific berry called the Aguave Berry, however you pronounce it. And these specific berries are going to be very important for the use of giving it to Munchlax in an area that there is a massive mass outbreak so that you can see all the individual question marks that are mass outbreaks in this area. So I'm going to give this over to Mai, as you can see over here. And then Munchlax is going to do a thing where the screen goes white. And Munchlax is then going to tell you what exactly is on the map. So as you can see, here is all the stuff on the map over here. Geodude, Graveler, Starly, just various other things here. But you also can notice that there's a species that shouldn't belong here, and that's Azura. Now, there are two things on this map I would like you to take note to. One is the berry on Wurmple, and two is the star on Munchlax. Now, this berry icon is to let you know that the Pokemon here in this area are going to be able to give you the same exact berry that you need to give Munchlax. So it's kind of like recycling what you get. So when you catch the Pokemon here or defeat them, they're going to drop this exact berry, and this berry is what you're going to be giving Munchlax later on. There's also another mark on the map. As you can see on this little outbreak here on this Munchlax, there is a star. Now this star signifies that this outbreak can be a little bit special, as it could have the possibility of having alpha Pokemon come in next as the next wave after you clear it out. Or you could also have the evolved form of Pokemon or a combination of it. So a bunch of Snorlax or a bunch of alpha Snorlax or just a good mix of them both. So these are fun to check out. So make sure to check out those in the area. Before we move on, I just wanted to show you the data mined shiny rates for the massive mass outbreaks that was found by Anubis. I'm linking them down in the description below. Here's a chart. We're just going to look at box number two over here, this section here, which is just going to be talking about the massive mass outbreaks. It's kind of the beige color. So alone, massive mass outbreaks give you a 1 out of 315 chance of it happening. If you have your Dex level research 10 over here and just have the massive mass outbreak, it is a 1 out of 293. If you have perfect 10 along with this outbreak, you're then going to have a 1 out of 256. If you have a Dex level research 10 plus the shiny charm, it's a 1 out of 241. And finally, when you have all the stuff together, Dex research level 10, Dex perfect, shiny charm along with the mass outbreak, you're then going to have a 1 out of 216 chance of being able to get a shiny Pokemon. Now, I'm going to be telling you about two places that you can save when doing these massive mass outbreaks. The first one is saving before you even waste your time giving the berries to Munchlax. Why? Let's say all the Pokemon that showed up on this massive mass outbreak were none of the Pokemon you wanted to see. Great. Well, then you can just reset and not have wasted your berries and leave the area and look for another massive mass outbreak and repeat the process again. After you know all the Pokemon that are going to be on your map in the specific area in this massive mass outbreak, then what you want to do is save your game. By saving your game, you can reboot and load up exactly where you are. So one of the first tips I have for you during these massive mass outbreaks is check every single one first. Do a fly through and see if you have any shiny Pokemon that are going to be in one of these without having to go into specific ones and catch them. So I'm going to go ahead and fly over all these and find out. You also get messages that say the rainstorm shows no signs of stopping soon. So that's pretty good if you're continuing to explore the area and not worry about it stopping, because the moment the rain stops, the mass outbreak disappears as well. After going through all of the mass outbreaks within the massive outbreaks and you've not seen a shiny overall, then you're going to want to do your selection process and decide which one you specifically want to go for. In this case, on the Obsidian Fieldlands, I might want to hunt for Scyther, so I'll go ahead and check that one out. But please note, by the time you do check every single outbreak, it's probably almost time for the game or the rain to be done, so you're going to lose that outbreak. So just reboot your game, get back in, and then head over to the target that you're going to want to go to. All right, here we are. It's so cool seeing an actual wild cleaver out here. All right, I'm going in. Ooh, a lot of cleaver spawning. Hello. Unfortunately, if you don't get the mass outbreak you want and it doesn't show up as shiny, the only way for you to come back again is to leave. But the difference is you won't get the same massive mass outbreak. It's going to be different every single time. The same thing applies to regular mass outbreaks. Now, as you can see, I left. I didn't clear out every single one and it's already gone. And there's different ones on the map. So remember, when it comes to regular mass outbreaks, now it's different. If you go in there and come out, it's a different Pokemon. They no longer are going to loop and repeat, unfortunately. Now, if you're going to be wanting to hunt specific Pokemon in this game, you're going to want to check out specific massive mass outbreak spots. So this is the Alabaster Icelands, where you usually would get your Oshawott to spawn if you are post-game. So you can also starter hunt using this. So this is great for finding out rare Pokemon and focusing in on those. So I'm over here. I'm going to look for my ASAP, talk to her. Give Munchlax those berries. We have two Oshawott mass outbreaks here, and we have a massive mass outbreak Duat. So we have three of the water starter here. Again, you can't chain these, so you're gonna have to save right when you get there, once you figure out this is what you want, and then go ahead and have fun. Oh, there they are. Oh, is that a wild Samurott? Whoa, 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 whoa! Two sticky gloves? I had no luck catching the Oshawott. I'm in the Crimson Mirelands, hoping for some Cyndaquil outbreaks over here. Let's talk to Mai immediately, because the clock is ticking. There we go. We have a Quilava outbreak. Let's go to that one. Oh, there they are. Oh, shoot! Oh, man, that's dangerous. Looks like the starters are all locked to where they would show up in their space-time distortion. So, as you saw before, Oshawott was in the Alabaster Icelands. You have our Typhlosions in the Crimson Mirelands, which most likely means our Rowlets are going to start spawning in the Coronet Highlands. That's how you're going to hunt all your starters in the game. You also can get Spirit Tomb and Unknown spawning in this area as well. So, if you're hunting those specific Pokemon, Crimson Mirelands is great if you're going for those. All right, let's check if we get our Rowlets here. Rowlet, 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 Rowlet. Okay, sweet. We have a Dartrix showing up over here on the map, and it's literally right by here, so I'm just going to go ahead and save, which means we possibly could get some Decidueyes to show up in the Coronet Highlands. This is so cool. Oh, my goodness. Here is... There they are. We got some Decidueyes. Oh, he saw me. They don't play. One, two. Gotta hit it twice. One, two. Rainstorm shows no sense of stopping. Reported Pokemon seem to be gone. We get a separate outbreak? Separate outbreak? No luck on that one. A lot of people are wondering, should I catch the Pokemon or should I battle them? If you catch the Pokemon and battle them one by one, they're going to be the exact same thing when they spawn the next Pokemon. If you do anything like multi-battles, maybe if you do 2v1s, 3v1s, or 4v1s, specifically with aggressive Pokemon, you're then going to get different type of spawns than you usually got. So that's why I told you earlier to save at the camp as soon as you get into the area. That way, if you decide to explore the multi-battle method, which would spawn different Pokemon, you will be able to do that safely by reloading your previous save from the camp. If you're curious about that topic, I have a video over here explaining all the details of this specifically. But all I'm saying is if you do multi-battles, the next Pokemon that spawn are going to be different than what you would originally have gotten if you single battled them or caught them one by one. And with that, you guys are now pros on how to do massive mass outbreak hunting. My name is Philly Beats You, and if this video helped you, make sure to leave a like button, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.